What's good, folks? It's Nightmare Frame here with a top 5 most overpowered melee weapons. For those who do not know, I did release a top 10 melee video with some great melee weapons you should try out. Now in this video, I'm bringing you 5 ridiculously strong melee weapons. Before I start, try and get your hands on Swift Momentum. It's an aura that drops from arbitrations, or you can buy it off other players. It increases your combo duration by 6 seconds and grants you 30% heavy attack windup speed. The best aura for melee weapons. Now at number 5, the Sephon Zaw. If you ever wanted to feel like a samurai in an anime, then this is for you. With one heavy attack strike, you're able to bleed enemies to death. Zaws are modular weapons, so this melee is built from different parts. The Sephon Strike, Peye Grip, and the Varjitu Jai Link. This heavily increases crits and damage and lowers status chance, but that does not matter as heavy attacks from Nikana's force slash procs. And for heavy attack builds, you really want to be in Zenerik, as this focus school grants you the passive way called Inner Might, increasing your heavy attack efficiency by 60%. Because if you're using any other focus school and spam heavy attacks too quickly with Corrupt Charge in the build, the mod won't have enough time to build up that 2x combo counter, so you'll only have the bonus combo up 50% of the time. So with Inner Might from Zenerik, you're able to spam those heavy attacks like a madman. Taking a look at the build, the stance does not matter. All heavy attacks have the same animation. I went with a lot of damage with Prime Pressure Point and Killing Blow. Prime Pressure Point for the 165% melee damage, and Killing Blow gives me 120% melee damage on heavy attacks and 60% heavy attack windup speed. The bleed procs scale very well from the damage. I have Primed Reach for that juicy range, Amalgam Organ Shatter for the 85% crit damage and additional 60% heavy attack windup speed, Corrupt Charge for the initial combo and negative 50% duration, Berserk for the attack speed when critting, Sacrificial Steel for the raw crit chance, and there's no point running Blood Rush if you're not going to have a decent combo buildup, and Lifestrike to keep your health topped up, and running Exodia Brave in the Arcane slot to replenish energy on heavy attack kills. Since this is a Zaw, I can run Exodia Arcanes on the build, and the Arcane is very useful on energy inefficient Warframe builds. It's a simple yet deadly build. Moving on to number 4, the Venka Prime, the best claw melees around, and with the Vermilion Storm stance, it has become the new spin to win. Actually, it is the most efficient spin to win, and it's the only melee currently to go above 12x combo counter, reaching 13x with 240 hits, so allowing you to increase your damage output to the next level. Let's have a look at the build. I have Vermilion Storm in the stance. I will be using the forward and block combo to achieve the deadly spin to win attack. Condition overload for the 120% damage per status effect on a target, Blood Rush for the 60% crit chance per combo counter, Primed Reach for the range, Prime Fever Strike, and Shocking Touch to make corrosive. With raw elements alone, you won't have decent status chance, so that's why I will use Weeping Wounds in the build, increasing your status chance by 40% per combo counter, Organ Shatter for the crit damage, and finally Berserker for the attack speed when critting. You can replace Organ Shatter with Body Count for the combo duration, or just use Swift Momentum in the aura, or use the Nerimon focus school. Either way is fine. This build makes this weapon disgustingly strong, but you can always switch it up and go viral. Similar setup, but I have Malicious Raptor in the stance. You can even run Vermilion Stone if you want, but Malicious Raptor allows faster strikes on a single target to burst them down incredibly fast, and went with the 2 dual stat elements to make viral. Drifting Content for the combo duration and status chance. Deadly and very efficient. Up we go to number 3, Silva and Aegis Prime, the heat-based sword and shield. The melee has decent crits and status chance, perfect for hybrid. Since the base damage is heat, we can mod it for corrosive and heat, with corrosive stripping armor and heat reducing the overall armor value, making this a beast of a weapon, and better than Sigma and Octantis. Taking a look at the build, I have Final Harbinger the stance. This is the fastest shield and sword stance, and has force slash procs, making it perfect for a condition overload build. So, condition overload for the damage per status, a Blood Rush for the crits, Primed Reach for the range, Berserker for the attack speed, Prime Fever Strike and Voltaic Strike combined make corrosive, Organ Shatter for the crit damage, and Drifting Contact for the combo duration and status chance. This is your go-to hybrid setup, but you can also go with a Weeping Wounds build for more devastation, replacing Voltaic Strike with Shocking Touch and Drifting Contact with Weeping Wounds. It's a very efficient killing machine. All right, at number 2, Reaper Prime, the king of scythes, heavy in crits and slash along with a decent status chance, perfect for heavy attacks and a hybrid build. Scythes became way more devastating after the melee rework, and Reaper Prime shot to the top as the best of them all, because of its versatility when it comes to modding. Taking a look at the first build, it's the heavy attack setup. The stance does not matter in this situation, a similar build to the Sephon Zaw Nikana, but I decided to combine the two sacrificial mods to increase the crit chance to the next level. I also have range and attack speed. I've added more crit damage with Gladiator Might. Keep this in mind, the final mod can be any utility or damage modifier, so Life Strike for the heals, Gladiator Might for the crit damage, or Dispatch Overdrive for the 60% movement speed. Perfect for speedster frames. It's up to you and your playstyle. And now that you've seen the Venka and its spin to win, Reaper Prime can also emulate this very well when using the Stalking Fan stance. I will use the forward and block combo, again similar to Vermilion Storm. The build will be your go-to quick attack, raw corrosive elements with weeping wounds for the devastating scaling damage. Blood Rush taking Reaper Prime into red crit territory. Now you can also run dual stat mods for another form of corrosive, similar effect if you want the added combo duration, and you can also swap that out to a viral setup since it's very high in slash, and both setups work great. And now we take it to the next level. At number 1, Redeemer Prime. I mean, most of you knew this was coming. A Gunblade. So it's technically a melee, but you shoot with it. Balanced stats, and the fire mode will proc impact and blast, making it perfect for a condition overload build, as blast counts as 2 status effects. And I'll start off with the crazy first build, and it's the corrosive and heat build. And since range isn't needed when modding for Redeemer, you can have some seriously juicy combinations. And what's also great about this weapon is that you can get easy headshots, further increasing your damage output. Looking at the build, the stance is the one and only Bullet Dance, Condition Overload for the damage per status, Blood Rush for the scaling crits, Berserker for the attack speed, Prime Fever Strike, and Shocking Touch to make corrosive, Weeping Wounds for the scaling status chance, Organ Shatter for the crit damage, and finally Molten Impact for heat. So now my pellets will be dealing corrosive and heat along with the blast and impact, and the damage can easily go above and beyond with the Helios with Detect Vulnerability and Gladiator set mods equipped on Deconstructor, going from orange to red crits with ease. And if you want more combo duration, you can replace a heat mod with body count. But remember, you can run Swift Momentum in the aura or use Narrowmon, where it'll have your combo counter slowly decay over time instead of depleting completely. And to boost the crits of these weapons, you have the Sentinel stat stake, the Deconstructor, and it's equipped with Gladiator mods that will greatly increase your crits to the next level. And as you can see, this is one deadly weapon. These are the most overpowered melee weapons and their setups, and they are definitely a must-have in your arsenal. Alright, that has been it for me. I do hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, feel free to leave a like, share, and
subscribe
for more Warframe content, streams, and so much more. Do refer to the description. Thanks for watching, and as always, peace.